Are you feeling good? Are you excited? We are very excited to be here for the WCCYM Weekend Online, aren't we? Are you
very excited.
Yes.
I can't believe it.
I know. It's finally arrived. We know you've been waiting weeks and weeks and months for this moment. We know we're not meeting in person, but we are here for the WCCYM Weekend Online this weekend. Thank you very much for joining us. This is Susie. Susie coordinates WCCYM. I'm Jonathan. I'm one of the youth workers within the WCCYM team. You may have been involved with WCCYM before. You might know who we are. This might be your very first time. It's good to have you here, wherever you've come from, wherever you're living, wherever you're watching this from. WCCYM is a group of local churches in the area of West Cambridge. Churches and youth workers, we get involved and work in schools, in those churches, in youth clubs, in different places. And usually we get together for a whole weekend. That's not happening this year.
It's very sad that it's not happening. Obviously it was meant to happen earlier in the year, but that wasn't to be. And we had this date set aside for doing a new one. So we thought, well, rather than cancel it completely, let's get together, do some stuff online, meet together, and have some things to do at home as well. So it's not our ideal plan, but we thought it was a great opportunity to get together with you guys.
Yes, so we have a whole load of stuff lined up this weekend. I just want to tell you a little bit about how it's going to work. If you've signed up, which hopefully you have, then you should have had a pack delivered to you in the last few days. There's lots of stuff in the pack, and Susie's going to show us in a minute what that involves. But one of the things you'll find is a timetable. And that timetable of stuff will tell you what's happening over the weekend. So let's just have a quick look at that just now. So this evening we're just doing a bit of an introduction just now, and then at 7:30 we're going to have our first session together on Zoom. Some of these sessions will be on Zoom. That means we can all be together and see each other and interact and have a chat and play some games. Some of them will be on YouTube that you can log on and watch at different times over the weekend. And there'll also be some stuff in the pack for you to do on your own at home. And again, Susie will tell you about that in a minute. So once we're done with this introduction, we're going to get together on Zoom for about an hour or so, and then after that at 8:30, we've got a time of worship on YouTube. It's a video that you can watch, you can join in with. It helps us to focus on God, to focus on worshipping Him, because that's really why we gather and get together. We want to have fun, we want to learn more about what God has to say to us, and spend time together doing that. And then tomorrow we've got a whole programme for the day. I should say at this point, if you can't join us for all of this, that's okay. You can kind of dip in and out, but hopefully you can make as much as possible over the weekend. Tomorrow morning we start at 9 o'clock with a workout, just like we would do if we were all together for the weekend. It'll be on YouTube. It'll be very similar to Joe Wicks. It might not be similar to Joe Wicks. I don't know. But it'll be a workout. It'll get you up and get you going in the morning tomorrow. Then we've got a time of focusing on God, a bit of a quiet time, and there'll be something in the pack for you to use for that. And then we've got a session on Zoom where we're going to focus on God, on what He's saying to us and what we can learn from His Word. Then tomorrow afternoon, we've got a few different activities that you can join in with at home. When we're together for the weekend in person, we would normally do craft and baking and some of those kind of things. And you can do that at home, but together. So we'll find out a bit more about how that's going to work. We've also got some challenges. Again, the stuff in the pack that will let you know how that's all going to work. That's tomorrow afternoon. And then in the evening, we've got another talk, a time of hearing what God is saying to us, some worship, and then finishing off with a quiz tomorrow evening. And then we move on to Sunday. It seems quite far away, but I'm sure it'll go quickly. On Sunday, we don't have anything that we're doing together in the morning, because lots of you will be involved with local churches. So we would encourage you to join in with what your church is doing online. And if not, then have a search for a local church and find out what's happening. There might be a service or something you can watch or be part of. And then on Sunday afternoon, it says on here, we have a live session where we're going to gunge a leader.
That's right, Jonathan. We're going to do it.
That's going to happen?
It will happen. We've got the gunge ready, and by Sunday, we will know what's going to happen with that.
Yes. I think you need to be involved in the Zoom chats to find out more about the gunging and how it's going to work, and voting for the leader who will be gunged on Sunday afternoon,
live
as part of our WCCYM Weekend, so don't miss that. And then Sunday evening, we're going to have a thirst youth service. We do this once a month anyway, and it's coming up on Sunday, so we're going to finish off the weekend by gathering together again on Zoom for some worship and teaching and chat and just reflecting on what's been happening over the weekend. So that's the plan.
So if you've got your bags, if you want to grab them now, your packs, then have a little look in them now. There should be different envelopes with different sessions written on them. So it should say Friday evening or Saturday morning or Saturday afternoon. So you can have a look at what's in there. So for example, the craft resources will be in there. So if you decide that you want to do the craft activity, you should have what you need there. But if not, you can just do it another time. There'll be the instructions. You don't have to do it at the same time as everybody else. And you might just see a few other little goodies in there as well, because we wanted you to be kind of part of this weekend and enjoy it as much as possible. And as Jonathan's already said, if there's different things you can't do, you can't take part in, you've got some homework to do for Monday, that's fine, just join in with the bits that you would like to.
Yes, okay, so we want to have a bit of fun. We have a challenge for you, but we're not going to tell you about that right now. We thought if we're giving you a challenge to do, then we probably ought to do a challenge as well. So we're going to cut across to our other outdoor studio and you're going to find out what we're doing over there right now.
So part of what we're talking about this weekend involves talking about emotions. So Jonathan and I thought we would do a little challenge. So what we've got is we have got these little emojis here, these little wooden ones. And what we'll do is pick one up, and then that will be the one that we have to show to the other person in some way. So for example, might pick up the happy one, and then we've got to roll the dice, and that will decide how we show that emotion. So for example, do the kind of happy one, and then roll a five, and that involves painting with teeth. So what we'll do is we'll do that, then the other person has to guess, but you guys can also guess at home as well as we go along, and it might be something you want to try as well with some other people at home as well. So yeah, here goes. Okay, so I'm going to pick my first emotion. Ooh. And now I'm going to roll the dice and see what I've got. Right, okay, you ready? So this is my musical interpretation of an emotion.
Okay. laughing? laughter. Funny. You can quite sad, like it's like you've got some loud and some quiet, like up and down, upset and crying, like tears.
No, that's good. I can do this again.
Angry. Really distraught. Sad.
Keep guessing.
Scared. Terrified. You're not angry. Tired.
No.
Like.
Come on, please.
Weary.
Keep guessing.
I might need to give up.
You're right. You're on the right lines.
Was angry, distraught, sad,
yes.
Upset?
Why like would, yes. Yes. Like, why would you be? Because you're like.
Weird, you know, like cry.
Yes,
cry,
that kind
like,
of thing.
Front of
tears. Do you remember what? What's on the list? Why might you be? You might be crying.
Leaving.
Yeah.
Sad,
because
upset.
Yes, because in you, you're feeling.
You're feeling.
You're something in here that's.
No, I can't.
You know, the thing in you where you might be really happy, but then something goes wrong, and your thing inside your chest.
Your heart.
Yes.
Or is... like heartbroken. Okay, here we go. Brilliant. And. Okay, so we're going to do all with the condiments. We'll go for some brown sauce. Oh, that's kind of upside down for you there.
Happy, overjoyed.
Yes,
happy. Yeah. Okay, so for my next one. Oh, you're kidding me. So I'm disappointed Jonathan didn't get this one, but it's fine, we're doing this properly. I chose this one, I have to do an interpretive dance, so I've got my scarves ready. Right, are you ready, Jonathan?
Yeah.
Can I go for two?
Bust. Angry.
Yes! I'm glad we didn't have to do that for very long.
So, yes. Okay, so now it's time to find out what challenge we're setting for you. Quite often, when we get together for a weekend, we would do some recording, we'd make some funny videos, we might even make a music video, and that's something we can still do, even though we're not all together. So we're gonna challenge ourselves to make a music video this weekend. We're gonna choose a song, Happy, by Pharrell Williams. We're thinking a bit this weekend about emotions, about feelings, about our emotional health, and so Happy seems like a good song to go for this one. What we'd love you to do is to record yourself singing, lip syncing, or dancing to Happy. It could be the whole song, if you feel up for doing that, or it could just be a clip from it. Don't worry if you are singing, because we're not actually gonna use that audio. We're gonna mash together, all of us, all the different things we're doing, into what should be quite amusing, and we'll be able to watch that on Sunday. So what you need to do is film that yourself at home, using probably a phone would be easiest, and then upload that into Dropbox. The details for doing that are in your pack, so have a look at that. If you're not quite sure, you can get in touch with us and we'll give you a hand doing that. We'd love that to be done by tomorrow afternoon. No, early afternoon, lunchtime? Lunchtime, let's
yeah,
go for lunchtime. Lunchtime. By lunchtime, that gives us a chance to do all that mashing up and making it look quite good. Yes, the song is linked here as well, so that you can get to it easily. So we'd love you to do that if you're up for joining in.
Great, so now we have got a talk from someone called Elaine Grant. She works for Cambridge and District Youth for Christ, so they're friends of ours over in Cambridge who do a lot of youth work in this area as well. And so we had asked her to come and do the talks for the weekend back in March, and so actually we thought, what a shame that she'd prepared all this stuff. And so actually we've asked her to put some videos together of those talks, so that's what we're going to show a few of over the weekend. So I'm just going to pray and then we'll watch that talk together. Father, thank you that we can meet together. Even though it wasn't kind of our original plan of doing it, thank you that we can gather together in this way. We can have fun together, we can get to know each other, make new friends, but also hear from you, hear from your word. We just ask that you would speak to us as we hear from Elaine sharing from your word. Amen.
Good evening. My name's Elaine, and I'm going to be talking to you over the next couple of days. I'm really sad not to be with you guys in person, but I have looked at the plans for this weekend, and it does look like it's going to be great. So, get excited. So let's get right into it. The theme for this weekend is emotional health. Emotional health. And using the Bible, we'll start to have a look at what God says about some of this stuff. I don't know about you, but the last couple of months have been, you know, a bit of a roller coaster, really, and I'm pretty tired, so it feels to me like this is quite a relevant topic. But I want to kick us off with a key verse from the Bible, so I'm sure it'll be familiar to lots of you. It's John 10, verse 10. John 10, verse 10, and it says, "The thief has come only to steal and kill and destroy, but I have come," It's Jesus talking. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy, but I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. So the key thing I just want to start with here is Jesus did not just come to change our behavior to make us like good. No, Jesus came to give us life, life in all its fullness. And he came to restore our hearts to God, to heal us. So anything that stops us living life to the full, Jesus has something to say about that. But what really is emotional health? What do we mean when we say emotional health? I don't know about you, but I love a good how are you feeling today meme. So just here you go. This is one of my personal favorites. On a scale of 1 to cat, how are you feeling today? Let's see if you can spot yourself. Did you work out which cat you were? Emotional health is, it's about looking at feelings and thoughts and memories and how we deal with these things. So some of these are nice, it's lots of nice feelings, and some of them are definitely not. And lots of them are in that weird in-betweeny bit. And everyone's different. Everyone has different stuff going on, everyone has different stuff to carry. Some people remember loads of stuff and they carry around a lot of memories. I can basically not remember what I ate for breakfast yesterday. Some people prefer talking about thoughts. Some people prefer talking about feelings. But all of us have this stuff. And honestly, we're not always that great at dealing with it. The way I think about it is like I have a bag, a big, invisible, imaginary bag full of all of my feelings and thoughts and memories, and I'm trying to work out how to live life with this humongous bag. But for today, the bag is, in fact, not imaginary. I've got it right here. Oh, weighs a ton. This is my bag of feelings and thoughts and emotions, and I wanted to just have a quick look at some of the key feelings and thoughts, you know, just the stuff that's right on the top. So what have we got in here? Oh, this is why it was heavy. Got some anger. I'm a pretty angry person. I get angry a lot. Don't know about you, but it's fun to carry around. Oh no. Got loneliness. It's like a big, cold, empty jar. Nobody wants that. But there it is. Ah, oh, I've got, I don't know, do you ever get irritated, like, with yourself? I get irritated with myself sometimes, and it's kind of spiky and weird-shaped. Oh dear, better pull this one out carefully. Got anxiety and worry. Might not look that bad from a distance, but if you touch it, it's pretty painful. It's not all bad, I don't think. Aha! There we go. There's some joy and some comfort in there. But there's lots of other stuff as well. Oh dear. There's those weird thoughts like, what if my friends don't really like me? You're like, why is this even in here? I don't even need this. This doesn't do me any good at all. Which is true. And, you know, there's bits of shame. You know that feeling where you're like, ugh, I'm the worst. I'm the worst. And you pull at it and it just goes on and on and on forever. It seems to get tied up in everything. But I do also have a fair amount of pride. Sometimes I think I'm literally the best. And that's just the top layer. I've not even got to the whole bag of stuff to do with COVID. Now, I know this is kind of ridiculous, and I'm sure that your bag looks totally different, But I'm willing to bet some other things will be the same. So I just want to recognise that some of this stuff is kind of grim. We don't really want to be carrying this. You know, nobody wants to be carrying loneliness or anger. But we do have them. And while we might be surprised that we've got them, it's not actually a surprise to God. So here's the newsflash. Jesus gets all of these things. Jesus gets these things. Jesus was and is fully human. He's not some kind of shiny superhero who doesn't understand what it is to find things difficult. He gets these things. I don't know about you, but I find that pretty comforting. So I want to just go through my five top moments where Jesus felt stuff, just to remind ourselves of who we're dealing with. So, moment number one. Jesus felt abandoned by God. Jesus felt abandoned by God. So in Mark 15 verse 34, this is Jesus is being crucified and he cries out, he says, my God, why have you forsaken me? I don't know if you've ever felt abandoned by God, but Jesus definitely has. Moment number two, Jesus felt sorrowful. In fact, he felt so miserable and sad that it wasn't enough to say, I feel sorrowful. In fact, he said, my soul is sorrowful even unto death. This was just before he was going to be crucified. He was in the garden. This is also in Mark chapter 14, verse 34. And he's talking to his friends and he says, my soul is sorrowful even unto death. Think of when you have felt most miserable, most sad. I guarantee you that Jesus knows what it is to feel like that. Number three, Jesus got tired, like physically tired. In John chapter 4, it says, Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired as he was, sat down. John chapter 4, verse 6, Jesus had done a long day's work, walk, and he was tired. So he just called it and he sat down. It's okay to be tired. Jesus got tired. You're fine. Number four, Jesus got angry. He got angry at people. Quite a lot, in fact. So in Mark chapter 3, verse 5, Jesus is surrounded by Pharisees. And it says that he looked round at them with anger, grieved at their hardness of heart. Jesus got angry with people. Sometimes that's the right response to things. And number five, Jesus was moved with compassion. He looked at people and was like, oh, I care for you. Matthew chapter 20, verse 34 says, Jesus had compassion on them. And again, it's all over the Gospels. So just to reiterate, Jesus was without sin, right? Jesus never sinned. And yet, Jesus got angry with people. He questioned God. He felt abandoned. He felt sorrowful and miserable and angry and tired. And he never sinned. So these things, they're hard to experience, but it's not wrong to experience them. We just need a bit of help in dealing with them the right way. So let's remember that verse, John 10, verse 10. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy, but I have come, Jesus has come, that they may have life and have it to the full. Jesus has come to give us life. So we need help to deal with some of these hard things, but Jesus gets them. He gets these hard feelings and he is here to help. He's here to give us life. In fact, he's put other people around us too to help. We're not made to do things by ourselves. So over the next couple of days, we're going to continue looking at some of the hard things that we can find ourselves carrying and at what to do with them. But for this evening, just remember, whatever it is that you have in your bag of feelings, Jesus gets it. And it's not wrong to have it there. We just need a bit of help in holding it right. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a great rest of your evening.
That's great. Thank you so much, Elaine, for just introducing that idea for us of what Jesus can do. We're going to be exploring more over this weekend about our emotions, about our emotional health, about what God has to say about that and in that, and what he wants to do in us and through us. So yeah, we're going to have more of that as we go over the weekend. What's happening next is that at 7:30, so pretty soon, we're going to get together on Zoom. The details are all in your pack. If by any chance you didn't get a pack, or you're not quite sure about this, or anything over the weekend, you can email info@wickham.org. That'll get straight to us, and we'll get back to you to make sure you know what's happening and how to get involved if you're not sure about anything. And if by any chance you haven't signed up, but you're still watching this, email us to sign up so we can get all that information to you. So we'll see you at 7:30 for our next session on Zoom. Let's just pray together as we finish. God, thank you that we are here together. We're gathering from all over the place. Thank you that you are with us individually, that you're with us when we are gathering and worshipping and thinking about you. God, we pray that you would speak to us this weekend. Help us to get to know you more. Help us to have fun. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
See you again soon.